twice more, and I'll probably hit my game.
That's the good thing about a shotgun, is that you got a spread of shot. You know that you'll probably get something.
Well, rabbits are pretty clever, and when they run, they don't run in a straight line.
They jump around in circles?
Not circles, but in a line.
Zigzags.
Zigzags, yes. And so, anyway, the point of this story is I always kept it behind the kitchen door.
Yeah.
And so it would be handy when I'd come home from school and I'd change into home clothes, if you will. And,
yeah.
Take my shotgun and go out hunting. Depending upon what season it was, I'd hunt for whatever was in season, rabbits and squirrels. And or if it was not in season, I'd be hunting for varmints and crows. Not that crows are varmints, but they do eat your corn if you try to grow
corn. Oh, yeah. That's when you were farming with your grandpa.
Yeah. My wife doesn't appreciate how much I learned from a year on a farm.
A year on a farm.
Now, I was not in FFA. My grandparents didn't want me to be in FFA.
Future Farmers of America.
Mm-hmm. And they were big on Robert's Rules of Order.
Oh, yeah, all that stuff about how you have to make a motion, et cetera, et cetera.
Yes.
Any old business, any new business, everything has to be done in order.
Oh. Yeah. So, my friend, I'll call him that for lack of something else to say. My friend made a motion from the floor that they open some windows because it was so hot in here. And the president said, okay. And they did the motion and it passed and they opened some windows so they could get some fresh air. And then my friend made a point of order.
Uh-oh.
And pointed out that he did not have standing as a member of the audience to make that motion.
Oh no, did they close the windows?
Well, that's not the important part. It was that the guy who was running the meeting had to admit that he was right and that he had violated Robert's rules. And so that was a coup.
He broke Robert's Rules of Order.
Yeah, so that was a coup. So I always thought, what a clever thing to do.
Oh, yeah. What a great little story. Thank you, Ed.
The conquistadors show up, and they're just... Tenochtitlan is this clean, well-designed city.
Ah, Tenochtitlan, the capital of the Aztec Empire.
And the Europeans were like, oh my God, this is so clean. How did he even do this? And they're so well built. You know, they're just blown away by the...
Yeah, technology. All these stone buildings and roads and everything.
Yeah. Putting the Romans to shame. And I was discussing this online. And
online discussion forum of the Romans? No, the... Spanish conquering the Aztecs.
Yes, and it was on a forum where you wouldn't expect a discussion like this to happen, but it did. And someone so vehemently disagreed with me.
What?
And I said, but you know, this is history. It's not, you know, I mean...
It's not opinion.
And he never ever accepted my...
Oh, he thought you were wrong because you were quoting the facts.
And he had, yeah, and he thought he knew something about it, but I think he was just a tourist in Central America at one time.
A tourist?
And had gone to several of the pyramids in Central America.
I remember seeing some people next to the main pyramid in downtown Mexico City. It's a ruined museum now. And this guy was actually telling his, he was a guide telling his group that the builders had levitated the stones across the lake.
Oh my gosh, that's cool.
And I'm listening to this, and then he goes, and then they had a new century, because for them, 50 years was like a century. And I went, 52 años, señor. And he goes, oh yeah, that's right, blah, 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 blah. Well, how do you think these stones got here? And I said, on very large canoes. So, this poor guy was one of them that you ran into online.
Yeah.
He said, no, it's not a fact. Don't you know the Maya were from Egypt? Or what, did he have an explanation? You have a good smile, you know.
Oh, thank you. Speaking of smiles, I've got to get this. I broke a tooth the other day.
Oh, that's a bummer.
And I went to see somebody yesterday, and it's going to cost me $1,000 to get removed.
Oh, no.